After walking through the Elysees for several consecutive days, I finally managed to board a freight train bound for Kazakhstan. The only money available in my pocket was what I had obtained by looting the Kremlin's vault, as all my air currents, including the international ones, were blocked. With my skills, I managed to stealthily enter a freight wagon bound for the conspiracy. I invested in this journey and paid for transport on through Azerbaijan, Turkey, and, finally, Egypt. All my destination remained uncertain. My priority was to distance Mazrov as far as possible from the spotlight. In Egypt, I finally secured a shelter to rest. However, my feet were sorry due to the earn-out choices, turning this moment into a real nightmare. Crossing this entire journey took weeks since my departure from Moscow. For a brief moment, I saw myself as a true outcast, abandoned by my people and discredited even by my generals who claimed insanity. My accumulated wealth was now at complete risk. I decided to settle in a more humble area of Cairo, where the less privileged residents had little time to concern themselves with global news. I was left with nothing but to rest alongside the camels. The next morning, I awoke to the courier's presence of a camel, seemingly intrigued by my intrusion into its space. I hurried to Shuitirui, as I'd sold Interfaur to deal with trivial matters at that moment. A young man named Amrn was supposed to come to meet me on a motorcycle to take me to a clandestine airstrip. As time stretched while waiting for Amrn, my anxiety grew, as my safety was at stake. Anyone could appear and их посе my presence to the outrightness. Finally, a sound resembling the roar of an old motorcycle reached my ears, it was Amrn. After a few uncomfortable hours on the back of that motorcycle, we finally reached the center of Cairo. The street was filled with people, and the crowd made it highly unlikely for me to be recognized. Amrn was trying to talk to me, but GS words were modeled and hindered by the English language. Even though he was making an effort to use the language, GS tangled with prisons made it difficult for me to understand. Suddenly, he turned onto a road that led to a distant wooden shed and drove the motorcycle there. As soon as he parked the motorcycle inside the shed, several men appeared, displaying clear irritation. The men who emerged were wearing Russian uniforms, and Amrn placed GS hand on my shoulder as he said,
"We need to reevaluate the deal."
Amrn glanced in my direction and declared,
"You are Vladimir Putin, and the whole world is searching for you. Congratulations for supplying our comrades with your funding."
It soon became clear that they were members of a nomadic military specialized in kidnapping outrighties around the globe. I had fallen into the trap funded by my own money. After extensive negotiations, I ended up conceding half of their money. I had to ensure my survival and proceed with the plan to reach the clandestine airstrip. But this part of the story I will share next week here on the Narratives channel. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and turn on notifications. watch the premiere video of He Putin, adds up, also check out the complete series of the first season of Ocean Secrets, India, the origin. See you soon. Goodbye.